So in this session, we continue from question number 3 from exercise 5.2, question number 3, arithmetic progressions. So we'll go for a screen share without wasting any time. Right, I'm going to start a PowerPoint presentation. In this PowerPoint presentation, we continue the problems starting from 3, and in that third question, third one. Yes, and I think you are all looking at my computer screen now. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the one. Now, question number 3 is 5-9 1/2. This is the arithmetic progression given, and two terms are given, A and A4 are given. A2 and A3 you have to find. So here the question is with the fractions. Therefore, the entire question I put it once and explain it to you. Here, an equal to a plus n, n minus 1 into d. I will change this one, children, a minute. Yes, a plus n minus 1 into d, it is not n plus 1, n minus 1 into d. Then a4, that is a plus 4 minus 1 into d. 4 minus 1 means it is 3. A plus 3d, a is 5 here, therefore 5 plus 3d equal to 19/2. 5 plus 3d equal to 19/2. And 5 is taken that side to have 3d equal to 19/2 minus 5. 19/2 minus 5 is simplified like this, minus 5. We take LCM 2 and LCM is 2, or you can multiply the entire equation by 2, like that also you can think. So by 2 if you multiply here, it is 19 only, and this also will multiply by 2, that is 10 whole by 2. So 19 minus 10 by 2, so it is 9/2. What is the answer here? 9/2. All this is equal to 3d. 3d equal to 9/2. Therefore d equal to 9/2 divided by 3. Division by 3 means it is multiplication by 1/3, is it not? 9/2 into 1/3. Now 3 ones, 3 threes. So 3 into 1, 3/2. So value of d is 3/2. Now 3/2 is the value of d. Therefore a2 is equal to a plus d. A is 5 plus 3/2. Again, here we take LCM. 2 5s are 10 plus 3, 13/2 is a2. In this place, 13/2 should be there. And then a3 equal to a plus 2d. That is 5 plus 2 into 3/2, and 2 and 2 are cancelled here. 5 plus 3, it is 8. So what are the terms to be in the blanks here? One is 13/2, another is 8. These are the terms to be in the blanks given in the arithmetic progression. Now let us move on to the next question. I think you understood this question. Did you all understand this?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let's move on to the fourth one. The fourth one is -4-6. So, in between, there are five terms, sorry, four terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. So A is given, minus 4, A6 is given, 6. A2 we want, A3, A4, A5. So 4 terms we have to find. So hint given is A6 and A. So here first term A is minus 4 and sixth term A6 is 6. Sixth, nth term formula we write again. Common difference is, what is common difference we don't know, we will find out first. An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, that is An formula. Then A6 is A plus 6 minus 1 into D, that is A plus 5D. A plus 5D is equal to 6. So A6 is 6. Therefore 6 equal to minus 4 plus 5D. This minus 4 I will send this side, it will become plus 4. Then 5D equal to 10, or D equal to 10 by 5. 10 by 5 or 2. Value of D is known to us and value of A is there. Therefore, second term is A plus D, that is minus 4 plus 2, it is minus 2. So in this blank, we should have minus 2. What is that? Minus 2. Next, we have A3, that is A plus 2D. A is, what is A? A is minus 2, sorry, A is minus 4, and D is 2, so 2 into 2, 4, 4 minus 4 is 0. So in this blank we have 0. Next, in the next third blank, that is term number 4, A4 is A plus 3D, that is A is minus 4 plus 3 into 2, 2. So this is 2. 2. Next, minus 4 plus 4 times of 2, that is 4 times of 2 is 8. 8 minus 4, it is 4. Now, in this blank, we should have 4. I hope you have understood this problem very clearly. So, first we substituted the value of A in the equation for the sixth term. Sixth term, A6 is A plus 5D. In that, when you substitute the value of A, we got the value of D. And we went on adding D to the previous term, that is the common difference to the previous term, and we are getting the other terms easily. A3, A2 we got, A3, A4 and A5. This is the problem. Though many terms are found, it is easy. Now, the next problem is also of the same kind. If you all make a note of it quickly, I will move on to the next one. Nivasini, are you doing it?
Yes, sir.
Very good, very good. Now we move on to the next question. This is fifth one. Again, we'll go for the nth term formula. An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Here we don't know what is A. A is not given here. And A2 is given 38. So we'll start with that. A2 equal to 38. A2 is 38, meaning A plus 2 minus 1 into D, or A plus D equal to 38. A plus D equal to 38. This is the first equation. And then A plus 6 minus 1 into D, that is A plus 5D, that is minus 22. Sixth term is minus 22. So A plus 5D equal to minus 22. A plus D equal to 38. We got two equations in A and D. That means two linear equations in two variables. So linear equations in two variables, a pair of linear equations in two variables. We can solve them in any way we like, either by elimination or by substitution, anything. Elimination is easy because A and A can be cancelled here. For term A, or variable A is having same coefficient in both the equations. So I am going to subtract equation 2 and equation 1 minus equation 2 minus equation 1 I will do. This is 1 children, 1. Equation 1. Equation 1. Minus 22 minus 38. So left sides I am adding first. Minus 22 minus 38 is equal to A and A are cancelled here when you subtract this one. Actually it is like this. Second equation I write first. Minus 22 equal to equal to a plus 5d. Is it not? A plus 5d. And next, second first equation is minus 38 equal to a plus d. A plus d. Right. When you subtract like this, the symbols will change. This will become positive. Sorry. Actually, first it is positive. First it is positive. Therefore, it should be negative now. Let me erase this. And this also I'll erase. So, first itself it is positive. Now, it will be negative. And this will be negative. This will be negative. So, minus 22 minus 38 will become minus 60, okay. Next, equal to a and a are cancelled here, plus a minus a, and we are left with 5d minus d, it is 4d. So, 4d equal to 60, minus 60, therefore, d equal to minus 60 by 4, that is minus 15. Did you understand this step, I think? Any doubt about
up to? Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Now, when you get the value of D, we substitute this value of D in the first equation, R, A equal to, from the first equation, A equal to 38 minus D, 38 minus of minus 15. So, hence, A equal to A2 minus D, that is 38 minus of minus 15, 53. So, in the very first place here, we have number 53 first. And minus 15 is D, so subtracted, 38 we got. So, A3 equal to, now this term we are, now A is found 53, A3 is A plus 2D, that is 53 plus 2 into minus 15, that is minus 30. So, 53 minus 30 is 23 here. Next, A4 equal to A plus 3D, that is 53 plus 3 into minus 15, minus 45. 53 minus 45 is 8. It is 8. This is 8 here. Next, we have A5. A5 is A plus 4D, that is 53 plus 4 into minus 15, 53 minus 60, that is minus 7. So, in this place, we have minus 7. So, this is how we obtained the values of all the four terms which are not given in the question. So, with this, we complete this particular slide, this particular slideshow. Last one, if you
sir,
want to show you again.
Please put the slide, sir.
Sir, what is the syllabus for PT1, sir?
One second. Wait. You all finish this one first. Those who could not completely write down, can do it now. Syllabus for PT is already kept in the group chart. You are not following, I think. First four chapters is the syllabus for PT1, real numbers, polynomials, then linear equations in two variables and quadratic equations. These are the four chapters which will come in PT1. Okay. We'll move on to the next question now. Next question, once again we'll check the arithmetic progressions again. Question number 4 onwards we'll see. And fourth one onwards, of course, single, this one is given. Of course, this is nth term. How to find the nth term? Once again, I showed here. And the formula for nth term is obtained as an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Understand this. So, an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Memorize it. Next, we have the fourth question. Which term of this AP? The AP is 3, 8, 13, 18, etc. is 78. That is the question. Now to do this, we start with our assumptions what is given in this series. This is the series AP is given. A is 3 and common difference D equal to A2 minus A1, that is 8 minus 3, 5. D equal to 5, and let the nth term be 78 here. Nth term of AP, of this AP be 78 now. So formula for nth term is n equal to how much, which is the nth term, what is the number of the term we want. So formula for AP, nth term formula, an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Therefore, an is 78. I wrote 78 in place of an. This is mere substitution. A is 3, n minus 1 multiplied by d is 5. Okay. Now 3 I will take this side, it will become 75. So 75 equal to n minus 1.
Sir, n equals to 16, sir.
Very good, very good. Now 5 is multiplying this side, let it divide the other side, then n minus 1 will become 15, because 75 by 5 is 15, and 1 I bring this side, so n equal to 16. Hence 16th term of this AP is 78. So given required answer is 16. Make a note of this one quickly. Then we'll move on to question number 5. Okay, right. Question 5. Find the number of terms in each of the following APs. So this is first AP. AP 1 is given here. This is AP 1. AP 1. What is there in AP 1? Let us see. This is AP 1. What is AP 1? 7, 13, 19, etc. up to 205. And in this AP, the last term is known. First term is known. That means it is called a finite AP. Such APs are called finite APs. Finite means number of terms is limited. Number of times terms is finite. Next. Which find the number of terms. How many terms are there in the AP? We have to find. So as usual, we'll write what are given. First term is 7, and nth term for AP series an equal to 205 here. Common difference is 13 minus 7, that is 6, and then number of terms n equal to how much, that is the question. Now nth term of an AP, an is given as a plus n minus 1 into d. A is 7, so an is 205 equal to 7 plus n minus 1 into 6. Same simplification here. We'll bring 7 this side so that it becomes 198. Is it 198? Yes, 198 equal to n minus 1 into 6. Now divide 198 by 6, it is 33. So
n equal 34, to sir.
34, very good. N equal to 34. So there are 34 terms in this AP. There are 34 terms in this AP. I think you have understood this problem. We'll quickly move on to the next one. Next one is an application type problem. Check whether minus 150 is a term of this AP 11, 8, 5 and 2. So in this, let the first term given is 11, and D common difference is A2 minus A1, 8 minus 11, it is minus 3. Then nth term, let the nth term be minus 150. Here we don't know how many terms are there because it is not finite. So we are letting the nth term, let the nth term be minus 150. Next, we know nth term of an AP, for an AP is given by an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So an equal to minus 150, now I have put it by our assumption. A equal to 11 given, plus n minus 1 into, we found what is d, minus 3. So 11 we bring this side, it will become minus 161. Minus 161. Or you can do like this also, first because it is the nth term and we have to simplify further, you can simplify like this. 3 into n minus 3n, minus 3 into minus 1 plus 3. So yeah, this 3 and 11, it is 14, so we will bring 14 once for all this side. Then what happens, minus 164 equal to minus 3n, minus 3n. Then n equal to minus 160, the both sides we have minus, so we can cancel that. Therefore it is 164 by 3, 164 by 3. So 164 by 3 is the value of n. Now tell me children, if anybody asks me how many students are there in 10th B, can I say there are 15 by 2 students?
No sir.
No, we cannot say
that. No sir.
So number of students cannot be a fraction. Or can I say there are minus 3 girls in a class? Not possible.
No,
so neither it can be a fraction. The number of articles, number of persons, anything, number cannot be a negative one or a fraction. Therefore this situation itself is not possible for us. This situation is not possible. Therefore what we do is, we will say it is not a term. When n is not a whole number, we say minus 150 cannot be a term in this AP. So minus 150 cannot be a term in this AP. So shall we move on to the next one now?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yeah. Prashant, are you following?
Yes sir.
Very good, very good. Varshita?
Yes sir.
T Varshita?
Yes sir.
Okay, okay. Next. This is question number 7. Find the 31st term of an AP whose 11th term is 38, 16th term is 73. For this, of course I made this problem in very simple small letters, so you can enlarge the screen of your mobile, okay, and check, so that it will be easy for you to identify what is given. You can enlarge a bit, enlarge the screen a bit, okay. 11th term A11 is 38, 16th term A16 is 73. Common difference is how much, and A31 is how much. Without common difference and without the first term, we cannot find what is the 31st term. So we will start with this. A11 is given as A11 equal to A plus 11 minus 1 into D, because AN is A plus N minus 1 into D. A11 is A plus 11 minus 1 into D. Or A plus 10D is what is 38. So A plus 10D equal to 38. Similar, in a similar fashion, we have A16 equal to A plus 16 minus 1 into D. Or A plus 15D equal to 73. I think you are a little bit confused here, because there is no gap between the equation and D here. And here also I will draw a line. So A plus 10D equal to 38, A plus 15D equal to 73. So from equation 2, I will subtract equation 1. Then what will happen? If you want, I will check it here this side. Equation 2
equal to 9, sir. Minus 9.
Minus? Yeah, but that's right, that's right. Wait. Wait a bit, I'll show you the subtraction once again. The second equation is A plus 15D equal to 73. So, A plus 15D equal to 78, we say. And then minus the, from this you are subtracting the first equation, that is A plus 10D. So like this, and that is 38.
Sir, that is 73, sir, not 77.
Sorry, 73. I understand. I'll erase this. 73. I'll write 73. Now, when you subtract, symbols are changed, minus, minus, and here also a minus, these two are cancelled. 15 minus 10, it is 5D. It is 5D. And
D is equal to minus 7.
That's right. It is minus, it is 35 here. It is 35. So D equal to, now 5D equal to 35, therefore D equal to 7. Did you understand how to get this one? I explained this side. Now,
yes,
so substitute this one in the first equation. A into A plus 10D equal to 38. Therefore, A value we have to know here. A equal to 38 minus D is 5. 5 into 10, 70. 38 minus 70, meaning 38 minus 70 is minus 32. So A equal to minus 32. I think you can see this. Let me erase, otherwise you can clearly see all this. See this one, A equal to minus 32. Now once we know the value of A and D, it is easy for us to find what is 31st term. 31st term equal to A 31 minus 1 into D, A plus 31 minus 1 into D, that is A plus 30D, or minus 32 into plus 30 into 7. 30 into 7 is 210 plus minus 32. That is equal to minus 178, of course positive. 178 is the value here. So, did you all understand this problem? Make a note of this one.
Yes, sir.
Of course,
yes, sir.
Wherever I am explaining like this, you need not note. Not all these red colored ones not required, because this is not the main problem. It's only a rough work for you to understand. You can make a note of this one quickly. Yes, children. Now, we are moving on to the next one. Here, that is question number 8. In question 8, we have AP consists of 50 terms, of which third term is 12. And the last term is 106. Find the 29th term. So there are 50 terms. That means last term is AN, that is AN is 50. N is 50 and AN is A50, that is 106. AN is A50, that is 106. So that we write. And A3, third term is 12. Therefore here A3 equal to 12. 50th term, that is A50 is 106. We have to find common difference as well as A29. Of course, common difference is not asked, but without that, we cannot find what is A29. And also, we have to find the first term. An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, A3 equal to A plus 2D, that is 12, the first equation. Now, the second equation, similarly, A50 equal to 106, meaning 106 equal to A plus 4090, 50 minus 1, 4090. So, equation 1 and 2 will solve, subtracting equation 1 from equation 2. 1 I am subtracting from 2, that means A and A are cancelled. 49 minus 2 is 47D this side, and the other side 106 minus 12, 94. 106 minus 12 is 94. So, 49 minus 2, 49 minus 2, 47 is 47. D is 94. So D equal to 94 by 47, that is 2. Next, by substituting this value of in equation 1, we obtain 12 equal to A plus 2 into 2, that is A plus 4, or A equal to 8. A equal to this 4 you send this side, it is 12 minus 4, 8. Next, value of A is known, value of D is known to us. D is 2, A is 8. So A 29 can be found like this. A 29 equal to A plus 28 D. It is not square, children. It is A 29 multiplied by 2. This is multiplied by 2.
Equals to 64, sir.
Yeah, very good. 56 plus 8, that is 64. A 29 is 64. Children, now eight questions we completed. 9th and 10th also we have to do, but okay, we'll quickly finish, then go for attendance. 9th question. 9th also in the same way we can do. Right? I'm moving on to the 9th one, right? Can I? Bhanu Prakash, are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir, following, sir.
Good, good. 9th question. In the, if the 3rd and 9th terms of an AP are 4 and minus 8 respectively, which term of the AP is 0? So here, let a n be 0, we have to find the value of n. And third term a 3 is given 4, and ninth term a 9 is given minus 8. A n value we know, and a 3 it is a plus 2d. A plus 2d is 4, that is equation 1, and a 9 is equal to a plus 9 minus 1 into d, a plus 8d, that is minus 8. So equation 2 and 1 will simplify or either add or subtract, so that we will get the value of one of the variables a or d here. A plus d value only, because a can be cancelled easily. A plus 2d minus a plus 8d equal to 4 minus of minus 8. This is equation 2. From equation 2 I am subtracting equation 1. So equation, actually, it is reverse. In reverse we have to have, this is equation 2 and this is equation 1. First we wrote equation 1, actually it should be like this. From equation 2 we are subtracting equation 1. Right. So a plus 2d minus of a and a are cancelled, and a 2d minus 8d, that is minus 6d, equal to 4 minus of minus 8, it is 12. So minus 6d equal to 12, d equal to minus 2. And once d value is obtained, we'll substitute this value in the first equation and get the value of a as a equal to 8, because a plus 2 into 2, that is 2 into minus 2, minus 4. A minus 4, 4 equal to a minus 4, that is a equal to 8. So once we got the value of a, let nth term be 0 here, and we substitute again the values of a and d in the nth term formula, and which will equate to 0, and find the value of n. So a n equal to 0, that is given. So a is 8 plus n minus 1 into d is minus 2. So again we'll send 8 that side. So n minus 1 into minus 2 is minus 8. R.
Fifth term, sir.
So therefore fifth term is 0 in this AP. So with this we'll close the class for today, and we'll see the remaining problems in the next class.